गुड मॉर्निंग। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट और चैप्टर नंबर फर्स्ट एस एस टी टेंथ क्लास। चैप्टर नंबर फर्स्ट इज फ्रॉम कंटेम्प्रेरी इंडिया, दिस इज ऑल्सो ज्योग्राफिकल इंडिया। इन दिस बुक वी आर गोइंग टू रीड अबाउट रिसोर्सेज, एग्रीकल्चर, ट्रांसपोर्टेशन, इंडस्ट्रीज एक्सेट्रा। First, we in this chapter we are going to read about resource and development, that what are the resources and how we can get development from by the using of these resources. First, we discuss about resources. This, what are the resources? The things that used by human beings to fulfill our needs. Just like we are using iron, so iron resources, iron is our resource and it usable to our fulfill our needs. We using wood, we using cotton for clothes. These are the resources. Everything which can be used by human being for fulfill their need. In simple language, हम कहें कि वो चीज़ें जो इंसान की जरूरतें पूरी करने में उनकी मदद करें वो रिसोर्स यानी संसाधन है। बस बट डेफिनेशन की बात करें तो द थिंग्स विच यूज बाय etc. You can also say that diamond. These are not on the basis of the reason. Second, you can. This is the both types are dependent on the origin. And in the next, we discuss about existibility. Existibility means existibility means that dependent of resources that can reuse or not reuse. It is also divided into two types. First one is variable, or second one is non-variable. Renewable and non-renewable. Resources are never met. Just like wind energy, sun energy. These resources which we can get after their recycle, after we reuse it, just like solar energy, sun energy, wind energy, thermal energy, we can use them again and again. That's never end. The resources which are never end. And in non-renewable, the resources which can end, just like coal, oil, petrol and things, a lot of things. The resource which can end after using them. We cannot reuse them or non-renewable resources. Next. Next we are going to read on the basis of ownership. On the basis of ownership. Who is the owner of resource? In simple language, we divide them in three parts. Private, or personal, second community, third one is goal. Got it? First private or personal, second one is community, and third one is goal. If we have a private agriculture farm, then it is the individual or personal or private. We can say individual or private or personal. If we have an agriculture farm and we have a lag there and many trees there, then the ownership of this resources is individual, private or personal. If we have a public park, then the ownership of this park is community. The living beings is used the park. Is the owner of this kind of resource is community. We can say that if a lake is in a place, then the owner of the lake is community or living of the living people of the village. Third one is government. The government considers as forest, river, mines, etc. The resources which are handled by government, used by government, or arranged their security secured by government. The owner of these kind of resources is government. The fourth one is another we can discuss here, international. International meaning ocean, continents. The ocean are property of all the world. It is not individual or any country property personally. So, on the basis of ownership, resources are divided into four parts, mainly three parts, and if we include international, then it changes into four parts. First, individual, private, personal. Second, community, third one is government, and fourth one is international. Now we discuss our next and the last on the basis of status and development. First one is potential, second one is development, stock, and third one is reserve. Third one is reserves. First, potential.
We are getting
by the help of technology. Third one is stock. Stock that resource which are available in large amount, and we know that how we can get more amount, but we don't know how to do this. Just like hydrogen is available in air, but how we can you get water from the hydrogen? And in this hydrogen gas, water is available, but we cannot get know that how we can convert hydrogen into the water reserve. These resources are reserved. If we are not using them in a proper manner, then in the upcoming few years, upcoming time, we have no found such uses. Just like water. For us, water, if we are not used them in a proper manner, then everyone knows that these kind of resources can